Yo, check this out. It's the Chocolate Boy, one of the Soul Brother, number one, Pete Rock. And you're checking out Craig Diggers. It came from my dad's records, of course, and listening to his stuff that, you know, his collection of 45s and albums and some of the sounds intriguing me kind of led to bigger things. A number of records, probably here maybe about 50, and plus my garage, you know, it's crazy in there. Maybe about 50, 60, and then my mother's house probably holding like 40. It's crazy with my pop's collection, because, you know, that's where I got it from. Just music itself, you know, the feeling of it, the sound of it, it intrigued us as a family so much, you know. And then listening to Bambaataa and Kool Herc and, you know, those guys who was the first school of hip-hop, who actually is hip-hop, those guys inspired me to do it more. By 13, 14, you know, I had it down pack. And then 15, 16 is when things started happening. My cousin Heavy D, rest in peace, you know, got his record deal. He kind of took me under his wing and showed me things and brought a lot of things out of me in music. It ain't really organized, so that's the thing. It's just I know where my shit is, you know what I'm saying? Just like, all I gotta do is see like kind of one record out the pack and know where I'm digging. Of course, I started going places on my own, going to record conventions, experiencing the world and finding out where's the dopest record, mom and pop record store. What I know about all three of these is that they're dope. These are joints that you can just play the whole album and listen to. These are great musicians on the covers, you know, except for, you know, there's really no musicians here, but I mean on this one. You know, thrift shops, garage sales, if you want to go there, you know, I've gotten a lot of stuff from places like that. Then it goes to digging all over the world, you know, and seeing it other places. Like, wow, look at this little shack with don't look like nothing's in there. You go in there, it's dust and it's crazy. You gotta wear gloves, masks, and you dig and you find stuff, man. Marva, Whitney, it's my thing. And also had Ramp. Never came out. This is not even the original. Ain't no original. No. Oh no. This is an ill album. This is nothing but rhythm and beats and drums and shit. And people probably have it. If you're a digger, you've probably seen it. So I was like, immediately started creating music when I was doing the I and I album. I found this one. It's a good album right here. Yeah, here's a nice rare funk soul album for you. This one. The Pezant Brothers and Buford Express. The infamous Skull Snaps LP.
What kind of music is it?
Funk. Yes. Just that cover, man. And the names, like, who are them cats? You know what I mean? Skull Snaps. What? And then you look on the back, you see this, you're like, I wonder. Take the plastic off and you open it and it's more weirdness, and you're like, oh, and it's this monster beat, man. It's like, whoa. Ridiculous record right here. I was all over this album right here. Man, I got this. It's very rare. Marvin Gaye album from 1964. It's coming up days. There's a lot of strings on this album, but it's funky too.
Can I see
that? here's a jazz record I use also. This me and MC8 use Soul Survivor.
One of my favorite joints. St. M.
Nat Adderley. Bunch of firecrackers and shit. This is the infamous album Tom Scott and the Honeysuckle Breeze with the California Dreamers, where the infamous Reminisce TROY sample came from. What intrigued me about this album was obviously the cover and the colorful little flowers and grass. He's in the grass laying down playing his sax, which made me want to listen to it. Classic material right here. It's just something I love doing, man. It's the inspiration of finding something like a piece of gold out of a big, huge treasure chest, you know? So records are like that for me.